We've had a lot of people writing into our YouTube channel and newsletter with this same question. What should I do if I have an egg allergy? Now, the simple answer is don't eat eggs. But I understand eggs are in so much food. So it's easier said than done, especially if you're eating the plant paradox way, because some of the most common egg replacements are loaded in sugars and lectins, like applesauce, mashed bananas, and vegetable oil. Not good. So if you're trying to avoid eggs and eating the plant paradox way, it's true, you've got your work cut out for you. But it's not impossible. In fact, with a little know-how, it's pretty simple. And if you're on the plan, you're already partway there. Because you've already given up a lot of the processed foods that have sneaky eggs in them, like candy, cereal, and pasta. But you may have noticed, even when you're cooking from scratch, it can be hard to avoid eggs. So what should you do? Well, first of all, if you want to check out a ton of healthy egg-free recipes that follow my plan perfectly, you should take a look at my brand new Plant Paradox cookbook. You'd be pleasantly surprised to find egg-free variations of many of your favorite dishes. But if you're cooking at home, consider these options. In condiments like mayo, try avocado, goat, or coconut yogurt. I like whisking together a little coconut yogurt and a little fermented hot sauce for a spicy spread, or simply mashing avocado into things like wild-caught tuna salad. You can also use goat's yogurt or coconut yogurt in a homemade tartar sauce, or even crumble in blue cheese for a sauce with buffalo cauliflower. So, if you ever come across a recipe that calls for mayo as an ingredient, but everything else works for you, don't skip the recipe entirely. There are so many ways to make it work for you. Now, you're thinking condiments are the easy part, but what should I do about baking? It's true, lots of baked goods feature eggs for structure and stability, but there are plenty of plant paradox approved ways to swap them out. Now, if your recipe has something like baking soda or powder to give it body, try adding coconut or goat yogurt instead of the eggs. 1/4 cup of the yogurt per egg. Or you can make your own eggs with flax seeds. All you do is mix 1 tablespoon of ground flaxseed with 2.5 tablespoons of water. Then let it sit for 5 to 10 minutes. It'll actually thicken up a lot. To use flax eggs, swap out 1 flax egg for every egg in baking. It's really that simple. Now, this isn't the perfect substitute. It won't work for things like meringue when you're relying on eggs for structure. But it works really well in brownies, cookies, cakes, muffins, and cupcakes. For breakfast dishes, now there is one Gundry-approved egg replacement that actually works for omelets. It's called vegan egg, and it's available online or through Whole Foods or other health food stores. It's made of algal flour and algal oil, so it's perfectly safe to eat. But maybe you can't find vegan egg near you, or it's a bit out of your price range. Well, it's pretty hard to replicate things like omelets without eggs. But one thing I like to do is saute all the veggies I like in olive oil, like mushrooms, onions, and greens. While they're cooking, I whisk together 2 flax eggs, cassava flour, and 1 little coconut milk. Then I add that mixture to a pan and create a sort of veggie fritter or pancake. A really satisfying breakfast, honestly. In fact, sometimes I prefer it to the real thing. For things like pancakes and waffles, if you're only replacing 1 egg, try 1 teaspoon of baking soda mixed with 1 tablespoon of vinegar. If you're replacing multiple eggs, use 1 vinegar egg for 1, and either yogurt or flaxseed for 2 eggs. You can also use pureed green bananas or green plantains. It's 1 little bitter that way, but you can balance it out with sweetness from in-season fruit, monk fruit, or stevia. If you're breading things, it sounds 1 little weird, but one of the tricks I love for breading foods without eggs is brushing them with Dijon mustard before breading in cassava flour, coconut, or almond flour. Now, this doesn't work well for sweet dishes, but if you want a flavorful, savory kick, it's a smart way to go. And remember, if you are eating prepackaged foods, read the labels carefully. Because serious egg allergies aren't things to mess with, and I want you to be safe. I'm Dr. Gundry, and I'm always looking out for you. Thanks for watching. Click the circular channel icon to subscribe and make sure you don't miss a single video. Click on the left to watch another great video, and don't forget to visit my website for more of my best tips, because I'm Dr. Gundry, and I'm always looking out for you.